So children, now we will be discussing about the certain properties of the elements when we move from top to bottom in a group. So let us see the first property, that is atomic size. Now what do you, first of all, you have to know what is actually atomic size. See what happens when you draw the diagram of an atom, what do you show? In the center you show the nucleus. This is the nucleus inside which proton and neutrons are there. The center, if I say that this is the nucleus and this atom has, say, first shell and second shell. Second shell is its outermost shell. So the distance from the center of nucleus to the outermost shell, first shell, second shell is the outermost shell. Whatever is the outermost shell, distance from center of nucleus to the outermost shell is known as atomic size, or you can also call it as atomic radius. So here I have shown you an atom in which second shell is the outermost shell. If third shell is the outermost shell, then distance from the center of the nucleus to the third shell will be the atomic size. So this is the atomic size. Now what happens when you move from top to bottom in a group? The atomic size of various elements changes uniformly. Now how does this change occur and what are the factors actually responsible for these changes, that we are going to see. What happens, actually atomic size depends on two factors. First is number of shells and second factor is the nuclear charge. So these are the factors on which atomic size of an atom depends. If you go according to the first factor, that is number of shells, you can very well say that suppose in a group, if you are moving from top to bottom, let us take first group element, that is first group elements are lithium, sodium, potassium, 3, 11, 19, 2, 1, 281, 2881. What do you see? That number of shells is increasing. Number of shells increases top to bottom. Means in a group, when we move from top to bottom, from lithium to potassium, we are moving in the first group. What is happening? Number of shells is increasing. So according to this, what should happen? The atomic size should increase, because the number of shells, as the number of shells increases, the atomic size increases. Atomic size increases. As the number of shells increases, the atomic size increases. Now, there is one more factor which I have told you about. This is nuclear charge. Actually, nuclear charge, if I tell you what is nuclear charge, you can say that nuclear charge is the number of protons. Because in the nucleus, whatever is the charge particle is proton. So all the charge of the nucleus will be due to that proton only. And proton only is the number of proton only is the atomic number. So if you see, as we move down, since atomic number is increasing, that means number of protons is also increasing. Number of protons is increasing, that means nuclear charge is increasing. So as we move down, nuclear charge is also increasing. And you must have studied in your atomic model that as the charge inside the nucleus increases, the positive charge due to protons inside the nucleus increases, what happens? It attracts the electrons which are negatively charged. What will happen as the charge inside the nucleus increases? The attraction on the electrons will increase and electrons will come closer to the nucleus. So, as the nuclear charge increases, electrons will come closer to the nucleus and revolve close to the nucleus, and thus the size of atom should decrease. So, according to the nuclear charge factor, since when we are moving from top to bottom, nuclear charge is increasing, so atomic size should decrease. Have you seen this? There are two factors. One is number of shells. Since number of shells increases from top to bottom, atomic size should increase. But the other factor, nuclear charge, says that since nuclear charge is increasing from top to bottom, and nuclear charge is actually the number of protons present in the nucleus, more the charge inside the nuclear, more will be the attraction on the electrons. Electrons will come closer and size will decrease. So two factors are saying the different thing. One is saying that atomic size should increase. Another is saying that atomic size should decrease. Now actually what happens, that this factor, first factor, number of shells, is the dominating factor. This dominates. So overall what happens? Overall atomic size increases from top to bottom. So this you can say, this by these two factors, that atomic size increases from top to bottom.